episode of Minecraft, Lord of the Rings. Yeah. So we are here in the Tower Hills, where we ended last episode, and we wanna go to Eriador to maybe fight. Oops, lag. Hope they are all here. To fight some invasions. To level up with the Blue Mountain Dwarfs and the High Elves, because right down here there's an area where both areas overlap, and we gonna spend a few days. Okay, we are at the border to Eriador, and yeah, let's take a look. We are at 760 with the Blue Mountain Dwarfs, and we wanna reach 1500. So, yeah, we gotta stay in this region and wait for invasions during the day, and at night we're gonna level up our troops with the spawning orcs. Ah, we got our first invasion here. Let's get these men away. These damn axe throwers are really annoying. Oh, and there's the next. I just was AFK here for maybe 10 minutes, and there's the next. And there's our third hillman invasion. Yeah, these guys are not that hard with my Gondolinian sword. Just two hits and they're gone. Yeah. Third invasion beaten. So guys, right when I'm leveling up my troops, there's another invasion up there, Gundabad, and you guys stay here because I need the alignment points. Yeah, there they are. Got my Warkbane, and we are almost at 1000 alignment now. Always switching between my Warkbane and my Orcbane, and drinking the Orc draught they drop to get more damage points. Poisoned my horse. Damn. Gundabad invasion beaten. The spawner exploded. Okay. Yeah, we got all the stacks and pouches of the orc bones and rotten flesh and all kinds of stuff, and the best scrolls and stuff we all take, but not the junk.
Okay, let's take a look. Oh, still here. Okay. 1000 alignment. And there's an area door watchtower. So my troops are down there. Let's see how far this warhorn can reach. Huh. Not that far, I guess. Oh, and there they are. Just as I moved, they spawned. Ready them. Okay, time to wait another day for invasions and wait for the night to level up troops. This takes a long while to get to 1500, but we'll get there. Yeah. So, I got the problem here. There are some boars without riders, although I didn't lose any fighters, and they follow me around. So they are not listening to my halt commands. And this is why you have to restart. And then, yeah, they are back to their riders. I think it glitches or something, so they get kicked off their boars. Now they are back. On boar back. Nice. And we got another invasion. This takes a long time. Waiting for invasions, and then this is an Angmar one this time. Always kill the archers first. There's another bombardier. Okay, got him. There's another one. Oops. Whoa. Some of these bombs do more damage than some others. Don't know if you can level up bombs. Too bad the bomb recipe is just for evil players. Okay, let's eat some more and get some draught, yes. Okay, Angmar invasion done. So just 44 points for one invasion, so we have a lot of work in front of us still. Let's throw away all the stuff we don't need. Huh. this takes ages. Because over there is another invasion. Just now it's Gundabad Walk one. And walks, I think, are the best invasions to have because they have seldom have armor. Just take two hits and give 1 point per walk. The walks just gives you half a point. Let's be careful here. Just mowing him down. Damn poison. Okay, let's retreat and heal up. Okay, they're almost done. Okay, I think the spawner just exploded. Yes. Okay, 1,100. This walk invasion gives way more than the Ungmar invasion before, but I think it slightly differs how many invasion spawner will spawn, how many mobs. Yeah, so 1,100. Okay, let's get back to our troops. Which I parked over here. And let's get them to work because it's still night. Let's kill some orcs to level them up even further. Take a look. 1100. And we need to get to 1500. So let's wait for the next invasions while leveling up our boar riders. So much fun just riding around with them, and they just slaughter these orcs. Okay, there's another walk invasion. Let's kill them all. Okay. Okay. Okay, Spawner is a goner. Oops, I hit the boar. Oh no, the boar is coming after me. The boar was just too much. I can deal with wargs and orcs, but boars, no. Ah, that was close again. Dang it. Heal up. Phew. These birds picking up my stuff. Don't take my mushroom pie. March pain. No chance. No chance at all. This is so much fun, but after a few hours of this war cries, kind of gets a little bit annoying. But yeah, still much fun to just massacre these orcs. Okay, it's almost morning. The last few orcs of the night. Yes. Another level up. Nice. So, there's the morning star. Another night in Eriador. Fighting loads of orcs, leveling up our troops. Halt our troops here. After another long night, look at this. We just need 123. Alignment points, and we reached 1500 with the high elves already, because as I said in the beginning, this full alignment area so overlaps here in the north of Eriador with the blue mountain dwarves, so we can level up both factions. And here we just need 450 to reach final rank of our Durin's folk. So yeah, we are getting there. takes a long time, but yeah, we are on our way to getting all the alignment we need. So guys, we are almost at 1500. Let's get. Oops, I turned the volume down of the dwarves. So let's get the last few alignment points we need. Look at this. 1500 almost. Halted our troops. Now we just get these half point orcs out of here. We reached 1500 already. Nice. Man, this took so long. So many invasions fought. Gundabad Walks, Gundabad, Angmar, Hillman. Yeah. And so over here is our encampment. There's a ruined area door house. Let's get this last stuff out of here. We don't need it anymore. I think we have completed our mission here. Let's get all these pouches emptied. We collected all the orc bones and all the rotten flesh. Almost all the rotten flesh. Yeah, look at this. Some more walk rocks. And the strange thing is, when halted, they just defend. So they are just these dwarves who get attacked will actually fight back. So here are loads of empty pouches we got dropped from so many orcs we killed. All empty pouches for our storage at home. So let's take a look what we got here. All our loot pouches. So here's our best blessed, enduring, masterful and swift scrolls. Some glowstone and even some mithril nuggets from these ruined houses. Sometimes they have mithril nuggets. We bought loads of stuff from dwarven traders. Glowstone, stone and Louis Gone. These are all the orc drops here. Yeah, loads of stuff. So, and even the small coins here, a few stacks. So yeah, so this was a lot of work and a lot of time. I think it took 1 or 2 weeks of playing to get to this 1500 alignment. Here's our arrow and crossbow bolt collection from the orc drops. So look at this. This is our leveled up troops now. We are Blue Mountain Noble. Means we can now buy war horns from High Elves and from the Blue Mountains. And yeah, we still have 420 to go for our highest rank of our pledged faction. Still fighting orcs over here. But they shouldn't get in trouble because each of these dwarves are leveled up. With each level they gain 2 hearts and a little bit more attack damage. So yeah, this is pretty cool. So let's get all our empty pouches here, our pouch collection home into the Shire, because we are finished here. I spent so much time in this region. Let's ready them. Let's get home. Man, this took forever. Let's get him home. Let's get him back to the dwarven keep. for now. Yeah, let's wait for it to render. Maybe they sometimes get stuck behind if you are too fast, of course. Then you lose some of your troops. So halt him here. I still have to build a way connection from the bridge to the road here. So let's take a look at our troops. If you crouch down, you can see the levels. Look at this. Yeah, they are all in the double digits now. Let's take a look. Our highest level, I think, is 24. We have a few 24 levels here. Take a look. They have 397 experience and 400 mob kills. And at 422, that's the next level. Let's take a look which our lowest level is. Oh, here's a 9 even. It's an old blue mountain dwarf. He just got 49 kills, so at 49 should be the next level. So I think he needs one more kill for level 10. So now we are back home. We can get all the warhorns we need now, but for the remainder of this episode, I want to get back to building. Okay, guys, look at this. I upgraded the tower of our Red Palace. I just needed something to put in these corners here, so I built this staircase here, which fits pretty good in there. So, yeah, a simple half slab staircase to the top here, with some windows in it. There's our olive plantation. Oop. Yeah, and you can overlook. There's our horse parking space on top of the Winehand house. So yeah, this adds another thing to our Red Palace. Did it on both sides. Finished the floor and did the carpet here. Yeah, now we have to build the other tower too, and maybe I even upgrade the roof a little bit, the black roof, because it's pretty flat over there. Yeah, but okay, let's do the second one. Okay, second tower done. Pretty easy. The staircases it took the longest, but it's not that much work. But we still have a bunch of things we want to do with our palace here. So yeah, this two towers, I think, really upgrade the look of it. I like it. So our labyrinth, our pool, and yeah. Back there's our guest house, where it all started. Our town hall and elven treehouse. There's our pillar from the last sub-episode. 250 sub-pillar. And yeah, let's get to even more building. Let's do some live streams. Okay, guys. Let's take a look what we built. Still haven't upgraded the roof up there from the towers, because it's still kind of flat, but yeah, these two towers make a whole lot of difference with the staircases in here. And yeah, we have these other two towers back here, and I filled them up too, but with a staircase down this time, because I started. Here's the way to our labyrinth and to our pavilion. Oh, and there's this little spoiler. Yeah, we started the underground of our Red Palace. I dug it all out and built the pillars and laid out the blueprints here, and did this glass sphere, or it's just a quarter sphere. Yeah, we need some light for the for the different plants. We wanna do a whole plant collection down here with all the saplings and all the different plants of the mod. Yeah, and I guess we have to remove this hill here. But yeah, so far it's pretty cool. Okay, let's take a look what else I built. I like this tower very much now. In the first live stream, I didn't show it yet. I built this winehand cellar down here. It's just the olives and the olive saplings and stuff from the olive plantation. But yeah, we have this backstory of the bad, of the evil Dorvinian winehands who trap hobbits and brew orc draught and stuff. And this is the cellar of their home. Here's some millstones you can use to grind down cobblestone into gravel, I think, and sandstone into sand, which I needed for all the glass. But then I got this idea for a secret escape route, and there it is. I built it all on stream. Yeah, it's just a tunnel. Oh yeah, and there's a puddle under this what's it called, stalactite, and there's even dropping some water down randomly. So yeah, just some wines and some candles and all kinds of different stuff. So in here you come to a build-up area, and there's a entrance only into a sewer pipe. Yeah, I made a sewer pipe for a Dorvinian complex, because all the toilets and the pool and stuff, they all need drainage. Yeah, we built all this here with clay and gravel and barn dirt, and yeah, all the dead marsh plants and stuff, and lots of small decorations. I think it turned out pretty cool, this little idea here. And here I wanna still expand the labyrinth, maybe do a retaining wall here to end it. We still have to close up this underside of the labyrinth. Yeah, and maybe expand it a little bit over here. We'll see how the outside area will develop. Okay, look at this. I upgraded the tower roofs a little bit more black up there, which is way cooler now. And I moved all my farms back there, and we have to build a path back there to our farms, because now we have this empty space here. I removed all the farms. And now we have some more place for buildings. I wanna maybe build an elven quarter here in front of the treehouse. So maybe over here could be the first house. And then some way to the windmill back there. Yeah, we'll see how this will turn out. Okay, look at this. This is the inside now partially developed. I did all the stairs and chalk stairs and marble slabs and dry stone and stone slabs, and these chiseled torches here and chiseled glowstone. And yeah, this turned out pretty cool, I think. We still have to remove all the grass. We have lots of spaces here for different plants over here, marked out for the different varieties of plants. Maybe we even can act like these are biomes or stuff. So yeah, this is pretty Pretty cool. I hope you like it too. Yeah, this bright ceiling, chalk ceiling, chalk stairs, and some marble, and some dry stone, and some stone. No, and now we put some plants in. The first plants and the birch planks for the rest of the floor. Very nice and bright, and some chiseled birch planks also. So, yeah, this gives a nice feel, nice and bright. And I got all my saplings here in two pouches, and I counted them all, and we have even some flowers and the special plants of the mod all collected together to get an overview what we all need and how much space we need for it. Yeah, that's pretty cool. But as you see, we got 15 and 27, so it's 42 saplings of trees we got. And if you type in sapling, then you can count there are 45 different saplings. And there are just two missing, the Kanuka and the mangrove, and the corrupted Malon, or was what it is, we can't get, because we are not evil aligned. But we just need these two saplings, and for that we have to travel to the mangrove down here. We need a mangrove tree, and then we need the Kanuka. Yeah, the Kanuka forest is down here, so we need to visit both of them. I think it's best to travel to this waypoint here, and then make a straight line to the Kanuka forest, because we could travel here, but yeah, we have to cross to Kanuka anyway. So I think it's better to not travel to the mangroves. But this travel has to wait for the next episode, because we are so long already. Thanks for watching, guys, and hope you see you in the next episode, and hope you like it. And please subscribe if you haven't. Bye-bye.